Hello students, good morning. Once again I welcome you in class 7th English. Now as we all know that our last chapter textual part is over, the remaining part is grammar and writing. Today I will teach you grammar lesson, and according to our chapter and our syllabus there is a one grammar topic, and the topic name is past perfect continuous tense. Now students, it is a very easiest topic because you, in your exam you have to just follow one formation, right? Now before I will start this chapter, this topic, I will ask you one question. What is the meaning of tense? Tense means time. Now the tense word is derived from Latin word. The word is tempus and it means time, and in English it is a tense. So this is the basic information, or very most important information if I will say. So the tense means time. Now we all know that there are three main tenses: present, past and future, and according each tenses have sub four tenses, right? See, there are three main tense: past, present and future, right? In all tenses have sub four, that is simple, continuous, continue, perfect and perfect continuous. Right? So each tense have these four types. Suppose if we talk about past, so simple past, past continuous, past perfect and past perfect continuous. If we're talking about present, so simple present, present continuous, present perfect and present perfect continuous. And if we're talking about future, so simple future, future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous. So these are, even all we count, there are 12 tenses. Now before I will start this chapter, from this chapter, which are the things that we have to learn? So number one is what is past perfect continuous tense. Number two, formation. And number three is rules, right? So first point, what is past perfect continuous tense? Now past perfect continuous means what? It is used to express an ongoing action that started in the past and continued until sometimes in the past. It means some action we had already started into the past, right? Ongoing action, and it is continue until sometimes into the past. It means nearly past, it is continue, right? So that time we are using past perfect continuous tense. For example, he had been driving for 2 hours, right? He had been driving for 2 hours. Wo 2 ghante se driving kar raha tha. If we talk about wo 2 ghanton se driving kar raha tha aur kar raha hai. So that time we are using past perfect continuous tense. Now in past perfect continuous tense or future perfect continuous, sorry, past perfect or present perfect continuous, it means both the tense, there are the two words. Number one is since and number two is for. Both are related to time, right? Both the words are related to time, but we are talking about, if we want to talking about pointing of time, or point of point of time, if we are talking about point of time, that time what we are using since. If we are talking about duration of time, that time we are using for. Remember, if we want to point out some time, that time we are using since, and if we want to talk about duration of time, that time we are using for. So these two words we are using in perfect continuous tense. So number one is over with example. Number two is formation. So each tense have, number two is formation. So number one is affirmative. So affirmative means what? Positive sentence, subject plus had plus been plus verb with ing. We will write V4 also, we will write V with ing, and we will also write present participle. Remember, present participle, it means verb with ing plus other words. For example, this example only we will take. He had been driving for 2 hours. Right? Second example, I had been running for 6 a.m. See that it is a duration of time and it is a point of time. So see, these are the two examples, right? So affirmative formation, subject plus had plus been plus verb with ing plus other word. So see that he is a subject, had, been, verb with ing, so driving and running, other words, so for 2 hours and since 6 a.m. So this is our affirmative formation. Then comes negative formation. So negative formation, very simple. Subject plus had plus not plus been plus verb with ing plus other word. See that here there is one change. After subject we will write had been, but here had, not and been. Remember this thing, that you will write whenever this negative sentence in your exam or in your exercise, remember that time you have to write down had plus not plus been plus verb with ing. So example, he had not been driving for 2 hours. And second one example, I had not been running since 6 a.m. Then comes interrogative. So interrogative formation, this place, only these two things, sorry, here. It will come here and it will come there. So what? Had plus subject plus been plus verb with ing plus other words and plus question mark. Remember, whenever you will write interrogative sentence, that time it is compulsory or it should be the question mark after your sentence, then after your sentence is right. So, had he been driving for 2 hours? Number one. Number two, had you, now I will change his subject because first person never asked to himself, had you been running since 6 a.m. So this is your formation. Remember this three formation: the affirmative subject plus had plus been plus verb with ing plus other words, negative to subject plus had plus not plus been plus verb with ing plus other words, interrogative had plus subject plus been plus verb with ing plus other word plus question marks. So this is your formations. Now then comes rules. So, rules. So, what is the rules or uses, when we uses or this tense? So, number one, so it is for something that started in the past and continued to the given, to continued up to a given time in the past. So, that I told you, right? First rule, we all know that it is started into the past and continue up to what? That given time in the past. So it had been running for hours, then this is also he had been driving for 2 hours. So it is started into the past, and first rule, it is in itself into the definition. Second one is for something we had done several times up to a point in the past, and continued to do after that. It means some action we had also done into our past, right? And continue we are doing. And it is what? And continue to after that. We had started into the past, and then after we had continued into the past, that time we are using this tense. So example, she had been recycling newspapers ever since she was a teenager. See this. It means for something we had done several times up to a point in the past. It means it is in the past. First of all, she was a teenager. When she was a teenager, now what is her action? That she was recycled the newspaper, right? When she was a young or when she was a teenager, that time she started to recycling the newspaper. And her action is still continue going on into the past. So the sentence is, she had been recycling newspaper ever, continue, since she was a teacher. So one sentence in perfect continuous and one sentence in what? Simple past tense. So students, this is the rule. It means what? Here, what is the thing? That when you are, it means that girl, when she was a teenager, right? You had, when you are a young boy or when you are in teenage age, that time you started some action and still the action is going on in the past, or it means in your backside, it means today, not yesterday. So what is it? It is we are using which tense? Past perfect continuous tense. Then here one is when we are reporting about something. We are reporting about something. That how? So, example, according to Mr. Amin. What is according to Mr. Amin? Mr. Amin ne bataya what? That he had been working in his office the whole day. See this. He was reporting. Who is reporting? So Mr. Amin. What is the reporting? That he had been working in the office whole day. And last one, when we want to talk about the cause, about the cause of something, in the past. It means something caused into the past and you are talking about that thing. So what is the example? Ram had been, sorry, Ram was tired. Ram was tired because he had been jogging. Jogging for 3 hours. So students, these are the use of our past perfect continuous tense, right? So students, it is very simple. So rules, then examples, then formations, and what is past perfect tense that I taught you in this chapter. I hope you understand this chapter very well. Thank you.